Hello there. My name is Mikko Hyppönen and I'm the Chief Research Officer with F-Secure Corporation, and this is the data security wrap-up for the year 2007. We've never received as many samples to our labs. We are now receiving, on average, 17,000 new samples every day, 7 days a week. And we're putting out over 5 updates every day, receiving or adding detection of hundreds of new viruses and trojans. In fact, if we just look at the last 12 months, in the beginning of the year 2007, we had total of around 250,000 viruses and trojans, total of 250,000 malware in general. By the year end, by end of 2007, that number will be 500,000. So it took 20 years for PC viruses to go from the very first virus to 250,000, and now we've doubled that amount in one single year. So the numbers are simply staggering. The one thing that has kept us running more than any other malware during 2007 has been the Stormworm. This operation started on the 19th of January when we saw the first spam run where they were sending out malicious attachments in emails. But they pretty soon started to change tactics as email attachments are stripped out by firewalls and email gateways. And they started to host their malicious executables on websites that were running on the infected machines themselves. And they would lure people to visit those websites by sending emails like this. You get an email telling you that there's a video about you on YouTube. Did you know that you are on YouTube? And here's a link to see the video. So of course, people get tempted and they follow the link, which looks like it's going to YouTube, but it actually doesn't. It goes to a website which might exploit your machine just by visiting the website. Or if you have an up-to-date browser, it will prompt to download a program to see the video, which actually, of course, isn't there. Since then, we've seen new techniques. These guys are running a vast network of infected machines, and they are using timely topics to lure people to visit these sites. For example, during Labor Day weekend, there was Labor Day greeting cards. When the football season started in USA, it was NFL-themed messages and so on and so on. But the really interesting part is the way this botnet works. In traditional botnet has a central server where all the infected machines connect to. Now this is fairly easy for us to take down. We just shut down the central server and the whole botnet basically dies. However, that's much harder to do with Storm, because Storm doesn't have a central server. Instead, these infected machines connect to each other in a peer-to-peer fashion, which means there's no simple way to take down such a botnet at all. And when we're analyzing this network from our own computers, and for example downloading binaries from one of these machines will auto-detect that, and they will figure out that, hey, that must be an antivirus researcher because he's downloading the same binary many times, and that machine will auto-retaliate and attack back with the denial-of-service attack, and then it will tell all its friends and they will all attack back. And this is the first time we've seen anything like this, a botnet that protects itself. In the mobile world, the big news of the summer was of course the launch of iPhone with the massive hype around it. iPhone is a very interesting device, and Apple has sold more than 1.5 million of these things, which is a lot of phones, but then when you compare it to players like Nokia, Nokia is selling more than that every single day. Now, iPhone has had huge grassroots movement around it about hacking the device, as it's a closed device. There's been lots of different hacks and cracks for it, mostly trying to enable you to switch from one provider to another, but also to add more functionality and features and new software for the device. And developments like these could easily lead to the fact that we might actually see malware for iPhone in the near future. It is perfectly possible for somebody to do a proof of concept worm or Trojan, which for example would replicate from one iPhone to another using text messaging or sending email. We'll see. On the traditional phone front, like Symbian-based devices, We haven't really been seeing much of new virus or Trojan movement. Most of the new interesting stuff has been around spyware or spying tools, things that are installed on the phone and will monitor what you're doing. And these are available not just for Symbian Series 60 second edition and Symbian Series 60 third edition phones, which are the most common smartphones, but also for things like BlackBerries or Windows Mobile. And then of course we had the news from Google. Google announcing Android and the Open Handset Alliance, a smartphone platform which runs on Linux and Java-based platform and will be enabling new kind of devices from manufacturers like Samsung and Motorola. These are expected to ship by summer 2008. And since it is a totally open device, an open source device, it is interesting to see what kind of risks we will be seeing with this device. If it is totally open, with no restrictions whatsoever, and any application can access the phone interface, it means that any program can make phone calls or send text messages, which sounds like a threat to us. Now, the SDK will allow you to restrict access to certain kind of APIs, but of course we won't really know for sure what the security for these devices will be like until we see the devices themselves. Talking about iPhones and other Apple-related things, Apple and Macs in general, especially Mac OS X, has been very clean of all kinds of malware, but during the last half of 2007, we started to see the first cases of it actually happening in the real world for real. The SLOB family of DNS-changing Trojans has been targeting Windows users for more than a year. These are typically distributed on video download sites, and they claim to be a video codec. Now, we are seeing more and more of these targeting not only Windows users, but also Mac users. So user tries to click on a video, gets a warning that it won't work, you have to download this codec, and if you're running on a Mac, it will give you a Mac binary and a Mac codec. You will have to install it and give root password for the installation to go through, but this is a new development and it shows that Mac now finally has the market share to become a tempting target for the malware authors. What else has happened during 2007? Well, there's been lots of talk about the new social networking sites like Facebook and LinkedIn and MySpace and others. And we see lots of risks when we're looking at these sites, but we don't see much real-world attacks. Sure, any personal information you put into a site like this about yourself can be stolen by anybody, especially if you accept total unknowns as your friends on services like these. But we haven't really been seeing much new Web 2.0 worms spreading on these sites, and we haven't seen much real-world phishing runs based on this information on these sites. What we have seen instead has been sort of combination of traditional phishing and targeted attacks. Attacks where the criminals first collect information by stealing a database or from some company or from somewhere else, and then they use the information about people in that database to make targeted malware runs or targeted phishing scams. For example, you get an email which will address you by name and knows where you work, and then says that your boss asked me to send this to you, or here's the update for the files you needed, and then that's the malware. Or is asking for your logins, your credit card numbers, things like that. Targeted attacks based on database theft. Then we had the incident with Sony, once again. We all remember the Sony Music rootkit from 2005. Now we found a rootkit from Sony USB sticks. This is the fingerprint reader that Sony used to make, which used the rootkit to hide your fingerprint information. Unfortunately, the same rootkit could have been used to also hide malware or other malicious content. And we found this during our normal work related to our Blacklight rootkit detection engine. So, that's it for 2007. Up next, 2008. My name is Mikko Hyppönen. Thanks.